Please subscribe to Morris TVGH.
Mr. Kari Samet's alleged house or alleged office and took pictures of a warehouse in addition to Kari Samet's riding his bicycle and put that information on the social media. You know, an honorable member of parliament must work with a little bit of decorum and truth to whatever investigation he is doing. If it is a congressional or parliamentary investigation, I believe this is not the process to do that type of investigation. You could have easily sent a letter to the offices of the Nehemiah group, invite them that he is conducting an investigation and therefore need a time with them. He would have been treated differently. He would have been ushered into an office and he would have been given records to show the work of the Nehemiah group. This was not done. And if you drive into someone's warehouse without notice, go to the parking lot, and you see somebody on his bike and you take a picture of him to show that you have done an investigation, I think that is descending into the terrain of propaganda rather than an investigation. The seventh allegation is that the National Cathedral Foundation used a fraudulent social security number of a deceased person to register the foundation. This is either totally false or mischievous, if I should use that word. The reason is that the tax, the employer identification number assigned to the National Cathedral Foundation USA was issued by the Internal Revenue Service of the United States. The National Cathedral Foundation has no business or authority to assign its own tax ID number. The tax ID number given to the National Cathedral is 9 figures, but the format is written for all companies. It starts with 2 digits, followed by a hyphen, and 7 digits to make it 9-digit tax ID number. A social security number of a human being is also 9 digits in the United States. However, it starts with 3 digits separated by a hyphen, 2 digits, another hyphen, and then the 5 numbers follows. So in this particular case, the employee identification number, which is also called the tax ID number for the National Cathedral Foundation, is 86-385-9197. The hyphen is so important because it distinguishes a corporate body from an individual. Mr. Okujeto went ahead and put this number in a different format, whether ignorantly or mischievously, to come up with the so-called identity theft. What did he do? He put the same number, but in different format. He wrote it as 863-85-9197. That automatically pulls a human being's social security number instead of a company's social security number. And that came up with the name of Jose Delgado that he assumed or mischievously circulated as the number for the National Cathedral Foundation USA. It is not true. Some of us probably have more credibility in the United States than a lot more people, and we would not be part of any criminal activity in the United States. If you want to be in trouble in the United States, the federal government is the last one you play with. And Dr. Polopoku Mensah did his PhD in not-for-profit management at Johns Hopkins University. He is very much qualified and understands these issues. We can leave the propaganda aside and be honest to ourselves. Not everybody will be happy with the government project, and that is how it is.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more updates.